Cross the Sahara Desert on self-built, solar-powered bikes, covering a distance of more than 7,000 kilometers as fast as possible.
That's probably the craziest solar bike race out there.
Entirely on their own, they have to defy the forces of nature to push the limits of their inventions and their physical strength. Technical challenges and extreme conditions are trying to stop them. Yeah! 18 teams from 8 countries are all coming to France's third largest city. They've all brought one-of-a-kind solar-powered bicycles that have taken them months to design and build themselves.
Together with my teammate Jonas, we are both 19 years old. We are the youngest participants in this challenge, and we depend on cooperations with companies to help us build the best bike. We are stoked to ride an Azub Twin tandem recumbent bike, so a bike for two riders with two seats behind each other. And the long wheelbase enables us to build a large solar roof on top. From putting our own solar panels on the bike and converting it to electric, building own batteries and developing an orientating system to increase our solar power, we did all by ourselves. Caused by delayed shipping time for some parts of the bike, we got the bike ready to roll just in time.
With their self-developed solar bike, they will attempt a 7,500 kilometers endurance race. From the start of the race, every team has to reach 10 checkpoints, bringing them all the way from France to the Sahara Desert. And the challenges every team has to deal with are unpredictable. With the race start set on 12th of April, we have to expect mixed weather, especially in France and Spain, and shocking heat in Morocco. Behind those machines are humans like you and I. They're determined to push the limits of solar bikes and their physical abilities to fight for the podium. A solar bike is an electric bike powered by the rider's legs and by the sun, with a motor to drive them forward and a battery to store energy produced by their solar panels. They will never be plugged in. For all those bikes, efficiency and high-quality components are essential to make it to the finish line as fast as possible and without technical failure. After hundreds of hours invested into the preparation for this challenge, the SunTrip Sahara race is on.
Let's go!
Let's go!
In this video series, we take you on the solar race adventure of the youngest and most ambitious team. Let's meet the German solar bike team.
I'm Kilian.
And I'm Jonas.
And SunTrip Sahara will be the adventure of our life.
During the race, the participants have fixed riding times. They are allowed to ride their solar bikes from 6:30 in the morning until 8:30 in the evening. Anyone who rides longer will be immediately disqualified. Traveling by bike means having a lot of contact with the locals, even if it is a race and there is no time for tourist activities. Part of the solar bike race is to camp each night where you are at the end of the day. The German team carries a tent and sleeps in various places. A beautiful field in front of a small town seemed to be a good camping spot at first glance, but it might not be as it seems.
It's the horror.
Ich hab so gezittert. Mein Herz, ich dachte, es fliegt gleich raus. Wir sind wieder da. Jetzt reicht's.
This night was horrible. Can't imagine, people came to our tent asking for drugs. They threw stones on us and they came with tasers, so we were very scared. But I guess we're not doing beach holidays, it's a race. And oh, it's already way too late. It's 6:30 and we have to continue. So let's pack everything.
Due to the extreme weather forecast, the Pyrenees were predicted to be a major challenge for all participants. Despite the bad conditions, they had a smile on their faces and pushed their solar bike a few hundred meters. The first checkpoint is done, but they have no time to lose. With sheeps crossing the road and increasing temperature, it's finally time to show the full potential of their bike.
We are now 8 days in the race, and the weather is very mixed. The last few days were quite hard for our legs. When we crossed the Pyrenees, it was raining, it was freezing cold, but now we are finally on our way to Maroc. To our advantage, we have an automatic tilting system that orientates the panel to the sun, and that way we can increase our solar production every day, and we hope to keep up with the others.
Technological advantages play a big role in solar bike racing. But to succeed at the SunTrip race, you also need to be a good navigator. Gambling between riding longer routes or deciding to ride more elevation are daily challenges. The riders are free to plan their own route but have to reach mandatory checkpoints in a given order.
Also mir ist bis jetzt besonders aufgefallen, dass die Leute hier ganz anders auf einen zukommen. Also sobald wir hier zum Beispiel am Supermarkt stehen und uns da Essen holen, kommen die direkt, fragen was es ist, sind super begeistert und extremst höflich auch. Und das ist einfach ein ganz anderes Miteinander, als ich es gewohnt bin. Also da war ich wirklich positiv überrascht.
With the sun in their necks, the German team is on high spirits as they make their way to Portugal. After 12 days riding from France all the way to Spain and Portugal, they board the ferry to Africa. With 3,000 kilometers of Moroccan desert in front of them, and only their legs and the power of the sun to push them through, the adventure is about to begin.